Around the same time I was starting my Etsy shop, I was starting my photography business. Now, I knew very little about Etsy whenever I started. I didn't know about variations or tag words or anything. I just was like, I have this thing, I should try selling it. But the one thing I did know how to do is I knew how to photograph products. I knew about light and I knew how to photograph stage good photographs. I quickly realized into my Etsy selling journey that this was a key reason why listings got traffic. Say I search luggage tags. When I search luggage tags, this is what pops up. Etsy's algorithm generates a list of thousands of listings based on relativity. As a buyer, I can only see two things: price, picture, and at the time it was two. Now they've added the average reviews. There's like a how many reviews there are and like what its average is. I am making a decision on what I'm gonna buy basically on two things: picture and price. And picture, in my opinion, is more important. Granted, you have to be like competitive with your price, but pictures are extremely important because they're what gets me to click. We live in a visual world. People want to see what they're buying. So if I want my item to stand out in Etsy search, I need my picture to stand out. That first thumbnail image that's on my listing needs to be different and it needs to be better than all the other items in that search. So if I'm gonna list something, the first thing I do is I go search it. If I want to sell a monogram Sherpa pullover, the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go type it in and look at what other people have. If everybody else has pictures against white backgrounds, I'm gonna go and take a picture against a blue one or a green one or outside, because that's what's gonna stand out. I want my listing to stand out to buyers as different and better. And I think pictures are the best way to do that. On top of that, Etsy has featured collections and gift guides. They scour their platform for unique listings that their buyers might be interested in. These collections have the ability to drive a lot of traffic to your listings, but because they are curated collections, Etsy is looking for good pictures that show off the product in the best light. Having good listing pictures increases your odds of being in one of these Etsy collections. On top of that, good images also increase the likelihood that your item will be shared on Facebook or Twitter or Instagram, and most importantly, Pinterest, because Pinterest also drives a lot of sales to Etsy. The next video I make will be how to get the good pictures. So I've hopefully convinced you that you need good pictures, at least one, preferably more, of your products for Etsy. The next video I make, which will be linked in the comments, will be about how to get good pictures. So I'm gonna share three ways that you can get good pictures as an Etsy seller, two of which are very budget friendly. I really, really hope this was helpful. Thank you so much for watching. I can't wait to show you all about the how in the next video.